Greetings to my Guru Bandhus and Bhaginis. Hope you are enjoying the Ganesh festival and wishing you happiness and prosperity on this auspicious occasion. My name is Aditi Modak and welcome to this new episode of Krupa Sagar channel. Today, we have decided to take your feedback on board and attempt to narrate this soul-touching true story in English. Some of our viewers would like us to use English as a medium of narration, so we can reach out to our non-Marathi speaking viewers. Your suggestions empower us to deliver, and so we are taking this on board. Please keep sending them and kindly like and subscribe to this channel. This will assure our videos reach maximum number of people and fulfill the divine will of our Guru Mauli to bless his bhaktas. The story I have been blessed to present to you today is mesmerizing. It witnesses the true power of our Mauli when it comes to protecting his bhaktas. When I first read this story, it brought tears to my eyes, and I'm certain it will be the same with you. So, without further ado, let's begin with the story. Kisan Rao Shawanji Mehre was a range forest officer at Pandharkauda and hails from Achalpur. He got married on 19th June 1975 and a few months after, in August 1975, was unfortunately struck with a rare disease called Guillain-Barre syndrome, or let's call it GBS for now. He was young, a mere 26 years of age. The local doctors advised his family members to shift him from the local Umri hospital to Nagpur Medical Hospital. As being a small health facility, they weren't very well equipped. So let us first understand what this disease is. GBS is a rare viral disorder in which the patient's immune system attacks the nerves. Weakness and tingling in extremities are usually the first symptoms. They further become rampant, eventually paralyzing the whole body. In its most severe form, GBS is a medical emergency. The exact cause of GBS is unknown. There's no known cure for the disease, but there are certain treatments that can ease symptoms and reduce the duration of the illness. In this case of Kisan Rao, the weaknesses in his legs had spread to his upper body and he was left unsteady and was unable to walk. This weakness further caused paralysis and spread to the muscles that control breathing, a potentially fatal complication. Up to 30% of people with GBS need temporary help from a machine to breathe when they are hospitalized for treatment. As per medical advice, he was admitted to Nagpur Hospital, but the doctors there also did not give any assurance of his survival. They informed that recently they had received 5-6 such cases, but unfortunately no one had survived. They had to reveal to the family members the dreaded truth that Kisan Rao may not survive for long, and advised that they were keeping the oxygen mask on him till such time he survives. Despite the difficult news, by the grace of God, he survived on the ventilator for 18 days. However, there was no body movement. Also, by virtue of continuously lying on his back in one position, he got bed sores. Doctors were not giving any hopes to the family members and were saying he may not survive for long as his condition was deteriorating. At this stage, it's natural for the family members to simply surrender at the feet of the Almighty and hope for a miracle. The family prayed to Gajanan Maharaj and kept their faith in him. O benevolent one, our dearest survival is in your hands. We surrender before thee to decide his fate. As those who have come to you have all been saved and you have not disappointed anyone. The family members kept the pariah reading of the religious texts praising Amauli continued for every day, and the patient was given Tirtha, the holy water, and Vibhuti, the holy ash. Then, as a blessing from our Maharaj, he started breathing. Doctors decided to take the oxygen machine off, which was the first sign of improvement. However, he was not able to do any movement, and the doctors further diagnosed that although he was out of danger, he may not be able to walk, at least for 3 years, and possibly crippled for life. The family did not give up hope, though, and continued with praying hard for his recovery, and every day placed flowers from Gajanan Vijaypothi after the parayan under the patient's pillow. A few days after, a very mysterious thing happened. An old doctor whom the family had never seen before visited Kisanra. He checked him and then asked if he had consumed any food after removing the tubes. Kisan Rao's sister said he was not able to swallow food. On hearing this, the doctor made an intriguing comment, which baffled Kisan Rao's sister. He said, from today onwards, he will start having his food, and left. The family members were left puzzled and started inquiring with the staff on who the doctor was. They came out of the ward and was searching for him, but he was not seen anywhere. One of the family members spotted him again and approached to speak to him. He spoke to them but had a very divine vibe in his eyes and surprised the family members even further when he said, I knew the patient, so I came to inquire about his recovery, which was very peculiar as none of them knew the doctor. This was a sign that the visiting doctor was no other than our beloved Gajanan Maharaj. This filled everyone's heart with joy. After this incident, Kisan Rao started showing progress in his health. Doctors insisted on the patient consuming animal protein for him to rebuild his health, but he refused, saying that he will survive with Maharaj's blessings only and was not willing to touch animal protein in obeisance. As the days passed, his condition improved further. Can you imagine this miracle when the doctors had given an ultimatum that GBS had no cure? The sister then asked the doctor if he could be discharged, but the doctor wanted to tackle Kisan Rao's bed sores that had increased due to lying in the hospital for so long. They wanted to operate on him, and believe it or not, the day fixed for this was Thursday. The day before, Kisan Rao's sister made a money order as a donation to Shegao seeking Maharaja's blessings. And they continued with the parayan and applying Angara, the holy ash, on Kisan Rao's bed sores before he was taken inside the operation theatre. Inside the theatre, another miracle happened where the doctors decided that the sores were healing and the operation wasn't necessary. My fellow Mauli believers, this is so astonishing and depicts how our Guru Mauli rushes to the support of his bhaktas. Kisan Rao returned home on the 21st of October to Atsalpur. At this stage, Kisan Rao was not able to sit but only could move his limbs. By December the same year, he was able to walk slowly and was showing signs of recovery. In the same month, he was taken to Shegao for Maharaj's darshan. He walked all by himself without support right from the bus stand to the Samadhi Mandir. He paid his respects and then made silver offerings on Maharaj's Mahasamadhi. By January, Kisan Rao rode his motorcycle to Shegao all by himself to take Mauli's darshan. In February 1976, he visited the hospital to get a medical certificate, and no one recognized him initially. When the doctors saw him, they could not believe that he had recovered so well and were very happy to see him hale and hearty. This was only possible due to Maharaja's blessings. In March 1976, he resumed office at Harisal and was leading a life of normalcy, and was later blessed with a son on 11th of July 1977. And friends, he named his son Gajanan. Anantakoti Brahmandanaraka Maharaja Adhiraj Yogi Raj Parabrahma Sachidananda Bhakta Pratipalaka Shegavanivasi Samartha Sadguru Sri Gajanan Maharaj Ki Jai. Namaskar.